What's up, gamers? DarkJake13 here with my first video of YouTube. I just got back from my local GameStop store today, where I picked up Tatsunoko vs. Capcom, both the game and the arcade fight stick. And I decided to do a little unboxing for you today for this. So, let's get started. Reach into the bag right here, and you pull out actually two items right here. Here's the game right here, but you also get these little trading cards for when you pre-order the game. Supposed to have 8 in here, there's 13 in all, and I believe a certain number of them were signed by the producer of the game, so that's pretty cool. I'll open those up in a little bit, I'm not going to open them right now. But here is the game, right here. Still sealed and everything. Looks pretty good, so let's go ahead and open it then. Get my pocket knife right here and let's open it up. Okay, let's take the plastic off of here. It's pretty simple. Now the game is free. Oh boy, look at that. Looks pretty nice, huh? Nice disc, nice little artwork to it and everything. There's the instruction book for it right there. Very nice. Looks like it's at least somewhat thick and whatnot. Pretty cool. Very nice. Oh, nice little back to it. So, there's the game right there. Now let's unbox the big item that I have in the bag here. The arcade stick. Let's take a look at this thing. Use this here, my receipt. But hold on to that just in case. There it is. Here's the box to the arcade stick. See right there, the logo and everything. Got the back right there. Some little side artwork. Just a little advertisement and whatnot. So let's go ahead and open this thing up here. Let's see. Oh, so I pull a little tab down right here. And what do I do? Oh, lifts up like so. And that's not versus Capcom. I need this arcade stick because that's how I'm playing my fighting games now these days. Wow. That looks nice right there, huh? Look at that. Very nice. Go ahead and take it out of the box here. Set that aside. Get off the little things here on the side, and there it is. This looks pretty nice, I gotta say. First thing I'm noticing about it, it's got a matte finish to it. There's no gloss or anything. Just your standard old Japanese style arcade stick. I don't think this is made with Sanwa parts. Let me see. Nope, this is not a JLF joystick actually. But it sounds like it could work. The buttons are not Sanwa either. It feels a little squishy though. I'm probably going to replace the joystick and buttons with Sanwa parts, so that way it will be at the top of it. That way it would be a top of the line joystick. But this looks nice either way though. The artwork looks great on it, right there. I kind of like the fact that they have the start and select buttons off the face of the joystick, so if you're like going crazy mashing buttons and whatnot, the start and select buttons are not up here, they're on top for you to avoid. So you don't hit them at, you know, a very crucial time. Up here you got your, let me see right here, your turbo button, the lights for them, your switches, home button right there. Back, not much to it really, but you can see the little dongle right here. This is what you use, I guess, to plug into your Wii remote. Since the thing is wireless. Let's see here. I just listed some instructions, just how to use the stick. really care so much for that. There's the there's the little dongle right there. I guess you plug right into the Wii remote. Let me see here real quick. Let me see here. Oh, plugs right in there like so. Put it down, start playing with it. Pretty cool. And there you go, gamers. That right there is my unboxing of Tatsunoko vs. Capcom Ultimate All-Stars for the Wii. I hope to post up some more videos later in the future. But until then, I hope you enjoyed this video. And I'll let you know if I actually get one of the 100 signed cards in here. I'm not going to quite open this up just yet, but maybe later on I will. I thank you guys for watching, and have a nice day.